one tool to rule them all.
Hey guys, what's going on? The reason why I was so weird just about 2 seconds ago is because I am incredibly excited to show you my favorite tool I've ever used when it comes to automating my company. Now, I've used a lot of different tools. I've spoken about a lot of different tools, but there's one that really ties everything in together. And that's why in the beginning I made the Lord of the Rings reference, which by the way, if you didn't get that, that was a Lord of the Rings reference. Yes, I don't have any friends or a girlfriend, but it's one tool really to rule them all. So if you have this one tool, it will allow you to connect so many different tools together, allow you to remove yourself from your business, allow you to scale, and allow you to do it effectively without human error. And what is that tool that I'm talking about? Well, of course, it's Zapier, Z-A-P-I-E-R, and they're called Zaps. And the essentially idea behind it is it's an if this, then that format. So you got to think of it like this. If something happens, then something else happens. Or if something happens, then something else happens, something else happens, something else happens, something else happens. So it's like a cascade effect. It's like a trigger, essentially, that's going on. And so that trigger action, the if thing, can be one of a million different things. They integrate with literally thousands of different apps that you can use. Stuff like Google Drive, Microsoft Word, Gmail, calendars, anything you can imagine is the if. And then is the exact same thing. Can be anything else as well. Google Drive, you know, Calendly, can be your Gmail account. It can be stuff like ActiveCampaign or email automations, whatever it is. And these two kind of work together so that you can have full automation running in your life. This is something that we teach every single Scaling with Systems member. And it's something that has totally transformed my life. Now, before I go any further, you might not know who I am. What's going on? My name is Ravi Abuvala. I run scalingwithsystems.com, where we help entrepreneurs grow and scale their company, totally removing themselves from the process using automation, delegation, and elimination. So like I said, strap in, get some notes out, because this is going to totally transform the way that you do business. Now, before we move any further, I know some people are like, Ravi, I don't have repeatable processes in my business, or Ravi, there's no way I can use this. I'm going to show you guys real life examples inside of this video of how we use it inside of our company. But also, I promise you, if you sit down with a pen and paper and write down a bunch of stuff that happens inside of your company, whether it's when you sign a client, what else happens that needs to happen after that, or maybe it's when someone books a time with you, what kind of information do you need to get over to them? There is a bunch of different stuff that you're already doing inside of your company that follows the if this, then that format that we can now automate so that nobody else has to do it again. And as usual, most of the software that I show you guys is totally and completely free. Zapier is free up to a certain amount, and then you have to pay a very little amount of monthly money just so you can have multiple Zaps or multiple steps in a Zap, but you can use it for totally for free for the first few Zaps that you use. And because I'm always giving free and valuable information and software on here, please be sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button down below, and turn on post notifications, and let's dive right in. So this is the website. I know it's very weird, Zapier. I don't know where the name comes from, but you know, they don't pay me to know where the name comes from. So Zapier, Z-A-P-I-E-R, is the name of the software itself. You can just go to zapier.com. If you go in right here, I'll show you what it looks like on the, if you're on the homepage, sign up with Google, Facebook, you guys know how it works. Once again, it's totally free. It says connect your apps and automate workflows. Okay, so let's just dive right into my Zapier account here. And this is kind of what it looks like. They just did an upgrade. It's pretty clean, but let's just dive right in here. These are what are called Zaps. And you can see it's just like a little arrow. If this happens, then something else happens, right? And these are just, you may recognize some of these icons here. Like this is Facebook. So this is like for one of our clients. Once again, just so everyone knows, like this is my demo account that I'm showing you guys in here. I have a business one that I'll show you that has a little over 360 Zaps inside of it. So that's for my companies. And we have over 360 of these individual Zaps that go out, and each of those Zaps have 5 to 10 steps. So we're very automated inside of our stuff. Unfortunately, I can't show you guys through that. That's for clients inside Scaling with Systems, and for my own company, but I'm going to happily show you guys a few of the ideas that we do use. So if you're creating your first Zap, it's very easy. All you're going to do is come in here and click create Zap. And then this is this. So when this happens, this is what you guys are thinking. So when this happens, then you want to do this, right? So there's a bunch of things I'm sure come into your mind. But let's just say, for example, let's say you run some kind of service-based business. And let's say that when someone books an appointment with you, well, you want them to be warmed up a little bit before you get on the call with them. And that's one of the best Zaps that we've used inside of our company, is whenever someone books an appointment with them, send them over some homework and send them over some testimonials. So by the time they get on the call with us, they're ready to rock and roll. So I would use whatever your calendar management software, we use something called Calendly. So you choose the app, you choose what exactly inside Calendly you want to happen. So let's say invitee created, then you click continue. We're going to click my Calendly account right here, click continue as well. And then it always wants you to kind of test and pull some data so you know later on which kind of data you're working with. So we'll just click test and review. It's going to pull one of the things that we have in here. Okay, perfect. And then if we scroll down, we click done editing. Okay, now it says this. Hey, when you get an invitee created, so when someone books a time in your calendar, what do you want to happen? So now let's decide what we want to happen. So I'm going to come down here and I use a customer relationship management tool, CRM, called ActiveCampaign. We use it for really a lot of email automation. That's what we teach inside of Scaling with Systems. And I would probably want to create or update the contact. And then I would choose my ActiveCampaign account. And then I would come here to the list view and I would choose, I know we have a booked call. So we have a, you know, obviously a bunch of different booked call automations here in list, but I would say a VA booked list. And I'm not going to go into an active campaign tutorial here because obviously this is an active campaign video. If you guys want that, comment down below. But I essentially have a list called VA booked that when someone books to maybe get a virtual assistant, a fully trained virtual assistant with us, then that triggers an email sequence that we give them down below. We actually give our clients inside Scaling with Systems the exact email sequence, but it's a 20 email sequence that literally gives them value. It shows them testimonials, it shows them social proof, it shows them, you know, me speaking on stage, so that whenever they book a time with us, they're getting warmed up so much to the point that whenever they actually do speak with myself and one of my team members, they pretty much don't have any questions on what the product is. The only question is it a good fit for them, right? So that's why we add them into this list VA booked. And then if you come here, I'm gonna probably have to blur this out here to respect somebody's privacy, but you can choose and pull pieces of data from other steps above it. So whenever you're setting what you wanna use, you can pull pieces of, you know, your name, information, questions, answers, whatever it is, from steps above it. So right here it asks for the email address so we can know who we're sending the email to, and I can just pull that right from the calendar event, right? The first name, I can once again pull that right from the calendar event, and it's most likely going to have a full name, not a first name here. Let's see here. There we go. And then it says, and that's actually in her full name, so let's go down to full name and put full name there. I don't think that this person actually gave their, oh, here's their first and last name. So this actually example, this person didn't give their first and last name, but that's actually where you could put your first and last name. You know, I don't know why this person didn't do it, but you know, for the sake of this video, let's just type in name here. Cool. And then we'll just say, this is technically the name of one of my reps, but we're just gonna put his name in there instead. Imagine that's the full name of the client. If you ask for their phone number, you can put their phone number in here as well, which is gonna be right here. And then any tags you wanna add, and any other additional piece of information, but we'll just click continue. You can click test and review. So I'm not gonna test it because it's a fake name, I know that. And then we're done. So now what happens is whenever someone books a time on our calendar, they're automatically put into an active campaign, which is an email automation tool, drip sequence, which puts which warms them up, shows them social proof, shows them authority, shows them me speaking on stage, and gets them ready for the call. So by the time my team member, one of my coaches, gets on the call, they just have to answer questions, and it's not like a hard sales close, it's not a hard sales pitch. We're just trying to see if it's the right fit or not. That's probably one of my favorite Zaps that we use. And then you can add another little Zap below it as well. So another tool that we use is something called Sly Broadcast. It's a voicemail drop software that automatically calls a number and just leaves a voicemail and doesn't actually call them, but it makes it look like I called them. And so we can start a campaign using an autofile, and it makes me sign in right here, but then I can actually have it so that after they book a time with us, then we put them in an email sequence, and then we send them a voicemail drop, and it's me speaking, and it goes, hey, what's going on? It's Ravi Abuvala here. I saw you just booked a time with my team. Super excited for us to talk. I sent you an email with a little more information on it so you can get warmed up for the call, and I'm gonna send you a few more emails over the next 7 days that gets you totally ready, answers all the questions that you have, and shows you some of the incredible people that we've taken from $0 to $100,000 to $200,000 a month inside of Scaling with Systems. Those are all true stories. They get to see video testimonials, screenshots, all of that kind of stuff, and they're warmed up for the call. And all of that's totally automated. So every time someone books a time to speak with us, it's like I have somebody going in there and handwriting these campaigns for them, sending them emails, and then it's like I have I'm picking up the phone and calling them and warming them up and doing a little voice touch point for them. But the best part of it all is that I'm not doing anything. It's all automated, guys. So that's the beauty of Zapier. Then you can just come up here and name the Zap. So I would just say something like booked call. This is how I name mine. Then I would say, you know, booked email drip. And then I would say something like, you know, voicemail drop, right? And then I'll delete this because it's not going to let me turn this on if I don't delete it. And then I turn it on and bada bing, bada boom. Now it's rocking and rolling. I don't have to worry about anything else. I'm going to turn it off because obviously I don't want people to be put in here, but you guys are going to get the idea. Another idea that I know a lot of people use, a lot of our clients use as well, is like Facebook leads. So you can make it so that whenever you get a new lead from your Facebook page, my account's expired because this isn't my right account, but whenever you get a lead inside your Facebook page, that then that lead, you know, gets an email from you, they get put in an email drip, they get a voicemail drop from you, they get a text message from you. Maybe if you're running this as a service for your clients, then you send this information over to your client, all automatically, all without you having to lift a finger. So you just build it one time and you don't have to worry about it again, okay? I'm trying to think of a few other ones that we really love to use as well. Let's see in here. Another really great one that I personally use inside of my company is that whenever we get an email coming in and it matches a specific search term, then we do something else. So what I like to do is, and you can see they give you examples right here. I like to say subject, cloud, or we'll just say recording, right? And what that is I'm saying, hey, whenever I get an email to my email address, ravi@scalingwithsystems.com, and it has a subject line recording, I want you to do this next step. So let's click continue. We'll click test and review. I'm sure there has to be some email inside of here. Okay, cool. So they pulled the email for me. I click done editing. And the reason I do this is because inside of Scaling With Systems, we do coaching calls. And whenever I'm done with a coaching call, I want to send that to my virtual assistant so she can upload it into our Kajabi course module so everyone can watch that coaching call and I don't have to do anything. So it's a combination of both automation and delegation. But once again, all I do is hop on the coaching call, click the record button, I hop off of it, and this automatically all happens with my team and automation in the background, right? So then I want, let's just say Slack, right? Then I want my team member to get notified in Slack. So, and when I get a new email with the subject lines recording, then I want to send a channel message. Of course, it's gonna make me sign into Slack here. So let's actually do this inside of, because I do wanna finish this for you guys here. Thanks for your patience, guys. We'll click Make a Zap. We'll click Gmail. New email matching search. If you guys are getting value out of this, please, please, please like and subscribe down below. I sometimes feel awkward when I'm doing these videos. I don't know if you guys actually like them or not. So make sure you please like and comment down below so I know that you guys are getting value out of this. Sometimes I don't know if the technical walkthroughs are as interesting to you. But so subject we said was recording. And then we're gonna come down here and click continue. And then we'll test and review. Make sure we can pull something. We should pull something. Perfect, there it is. So then we'll click done editing. Then we're gonna come here, we're gonna go down to Slack. We're gonna choose the event, send channel message, select the account for Slack, and you would just sign into your Slack account here. Then you would choose the channel. I already have a recording channel, Zoom recording, because I already do this. Like again, I'm showing you guys exactly what we do. And then you can say something like, hey, Mel Jane, which is the name of my virtual assistant. Here is a new recording from the coaching call. Please upload into Kajabi ASAP. Thanks. And then I'll come to show all options. And then inside of here, it says, hi, Ravi Abuvala, your cloud recording is now available. And then it's gonna go, I can put the actual body inside of it, and you can put the HTML body in it as well. And essentially what it would say under here is you want to say as a bot, you can know the bot name, all that stuff doesn't really matter. And then you click continue. And then you would essentially test and review. And then boom, you see this right here. It's now showing, hey, click here for host only. You can click here to view your recording. And then if I went into my Zoom recording channel here, I think I actually turned it off so I don't have to keep on getting notified by it. It shows, hey, here's a link to the recording inside of your inside of the actual recording itself. So now my assistant gets an email whenever Zoom sends me the link to the recording of the coaching call I just did, so that she can upload it into Kajabi and I don't have to do anything. So that's just one example of literally 2 million examples of things that you can do inside of Kajabi, or inside of Zapier, excuse me. And if you guys want some like some ideas or some motivation or something like that, you can actually go down to Explore. And then you can start typing in apps and it will show you, like, it already auto-populated like 15 apps for me. Add new lead information to Google Sheets and Gmail from a web work. Save a new Gmail attachments to Google Drive, right? Send emails via Gmail when Google Sheets are uploaded. Send Gmail messages when contacts are added to ClickFunnels, right? So you can see popular apps for each of these softwares. So one of the things you could do is come in here. I don't know why they auto-populate all of these things. It's so annoying. I'm so sorry, guys. Let me exit out of this stuff real quick so I can show you. You can literally type in, hey, Ravi, I don't know what kind of apps I would want to run. Well, you just come in here and type in, and maybe you use Calendly, right? And then maybe you also use Google Gmail. So then you can click these two together, and then it's going to show you, get a scheduled digest of new Calendly events via email. So it's like, hey, Ravi, this is Ravi emailing you, letting you know that, hey, here's James, here's all of this information, you have a call with him later on. And then you can have, a bunch of different other zaps. These are called zaps here, zaps ideas. And you can just click on it and it's automatically gonna pull that up for you as well, right? So I dare you, I think they said they have over, what was the number that they had in here? They have like literally millions, not millions, that's obviously an exaggeration, but thousands of apps inside of here that you can choose from. 2,000 apps. So, you know, millions, 2,000s, what's the difference? But yeah, you guys get the idea right here. You just go to the Explore page and you can kind of get an idea inside as far as which exact Zap you want to run, or what the tools that you have, what softwares that you have that can be combined together inside of Zapier. So Zapier is a tool that we've used to totally transform the way that we do business and the way that our clients do business, because you should always automate before you give it to somebody else. So check and see if you or someone in your company is doing something mundane, repetitive over and over and over again, and put it into a Zap so you can free up their time and also remove the human error that happens whenever somebody runs something by themselves. Awesome, guys. So there you go. That is a full breakdown of Zapier and how we use it inside of our company, as well as some specific Zapier examples that you can use inside of your company in order to remove yourself from the process. Now, you know actually how to run Zapier, but you heard me use words like automation, delegation, elimination. How do you know which one you're supposed to do for what task, and how do you eliminate, and where do you find fully trained virtual assistants? Well, I created a free course for you. That's right, an entire free course where you can go through and understand a lot more automation, delegation, and elimination. It's called 3 Steps to Scale. The link to it's going to be down in the comments. And we walk you through which order you're supposed to do for those exact same things, what you should be eliminating before you automate, what you should be automating before you delegate, and when you're delegating, where to find employees, what to give them tasks to do, how to create standard operating procedures, et cetera, et cetera. So click the link down in the description below and get access to that ASAP. Finally, once again, guys, like I said earlier on the video, I always don't know, like, do you guys like more if I'm looking at the camera and just walking you through high level stuff? Do you guys like when I'm doing technical breakdowns of softwares and apps that we use inside of our company? Please do me the favor and comment down below if you enjoyed this video. Make sure you like it and subscribe to the channel so that I know that these kind of videos are the things that you like. And then give me an idea in the comments down below. What are some tasks that you're running inside your company that you want to be automated that maybe you don't know if can be used with Zapier? This is probably my favorite tool and I love helping people out. So drop down some kind of questions down below about the apps that you're using or tasks that you're doing and you want to know if they can be automated, and I'll personally come in there and answer those questions for you. Thank you guys so much for watching the channel. I appreciate all of your time as usual, and I'll see you in the comments.